is in the top 10, including Toyota, I'm saying. They are not. Because that particular, you know, they tried to get into everything and botched it up. So branding is also about, it's a strategy about saying no to a few things which might be attractive.
Yeah.
Now, if you have been able to do that, then investment flow comes. Okay. The other thing that I would say, see, the world itself is today moving to what is known as gig economy. And this COVID has further, you know, emphasized it, catalyzed it, whatever you like to say. So what requires, because Bangladeshis, I mean, internationally speaking, if I were to talk, I mean, even you can see that Hofstede insights are known to be very genuine and very, humble people. Okay. Now, this is a strength which you can either leverage or you can be ashamed of. Currently speaking, without any hard feelings, Bangladeshis are ashamed of this. Being humble, being kind is nothing bad, but they are ashamed. And therefore, in the world market, they are paid differently.
Yeah.
No. So how do we leverage this? And if you are able to leverage this, then the flow of funds will begin. Because from whatever I'm seeing, your government is taking all the right kind of steps. Okay. Now, therein comes education. Okay. This, this particular obsession with getting a foreign education is where I think the entire SAARC region is making a mistake. Okay, I feel it is. I mean, if we teach in our business school, we will pick up a Harvard case study as if it's, which has no relevance for our students.
Yes.
Okay. But if we were to, Bangladeshize it or Indianize the education and look at it from that standpoint, then we will discover that our humility, our kindness, our friendliness is going to be our strengths.
So exactly.
But
exactly.
Yes, sir?
I would like to ask you one particular question in this regard, because Bangladesh is the second largest ready-made garment exporter.
I know. Bangladesh, that's what I
heard. Yeah. Bangladesh has the highest number of grain RMZ factories currently.
Correct. But I know, sir.
But it is actually our mistake that we don't have any own brand. Currently, we are manufacturing product for Zara, for JCPenney, for Walmart, for XYZ, other brands. But all these are manufacturing in Bangladesh. Why not there will be a clothing brand? What is that brand will be owned by Bangladeshis and it will be marketed throughout the globe. So what is your advice to prepare a Bangladeshi brand ready-made garments?
My advice is Bangladesh, in terms of product quality and service delivery, has established itself. Otherwise, it wouldn't have been the world number two.
Yeah.
All right. The need now is to first establish the country as a brand. Okay. Which is not there. This is the reason. This is the reason why you have no other option but to do some contract working. This is the reason. So if Bangladesh were to first work, which is, I'm talking of, your organizations, your government and private sector put together to say, okay, now what are the three or four points where we can differentiate? It'll be tough to find. It'll take a little time, but it is not impossible. Okay. Once you have established brand Bangladesh, then look at it, look at the textile unit, and then establish that brand, riding brand Bangladesh. You see, the BMWs and the Mercedes would be nothing if the German branding was not there.
Yeah.
Okay. I was selling tires and, I was working for Pirelli tires. So Pirelli has some 27, 28 factories in all locations. Okay. Now, when selling the tire, they ask that, please tell us where this particular tire originates. If it was German, they were willing to pay almost 50% more. The company is the same. The product is the same. The quality is the same. And we had a big, tough time. Okay. So that is the reason why you very rightly started as to why developing a national brand is important. And once you have built that, and then when you go for developing a brand for any of the products, then you identify which are your strong points. Don't like Japan, get into everything. Okay. Or don't like Korea because they rose and then everything kind of stopped or the growth has stunted. So you pick 3, 4, 5 things and piggyback on the brand Bangladesh.
Exactly, sir. Actually, beside ready-made garments, Bangladeshi leather goods are doing very well. Bangladeshi pharmaceutical sector is doing well. Bangladeshi agro-processing sector is doing well. So what is your advice? For example, Bangladesh is currently producing about 7% of global leather production, and we need only 4% of them. Rest 3% we have surplus. So if we manufacture leather goods here and export it to Japan, export it to Korea or European market, then it could be even 10 or 8 folds of price. So what is your advice how this second or third sector will come up?
So once, now this is what I'm saying. Once the basic brand Bangladesh is known for producing quality, that is established, accepting that it is outsourced.
Yeah.
Okay. So now to brand these products and to get, I mean, branding naturally gives you a much higher value than what you get out as a commodity. Right now, textile, leather, you know, agro products, all these are WIIFMs of the world.
Yeah.
You know, like I just said, roti, kapda, makan. Yeah. This is established that you're making world class. Because that's the reason why it's being bought across the world. But your country is yet to be known as that center of excellence. You are selling under other brands. So, and that you're forced to do that. The reason is that first, Bangladesh as a brand must be known. Okay, this is what Japan did ages back. You know, when we were kids, we used to say this is a Japani gudiya, you know, you and I when we were kids, which was fragile. Until Japan realized, no, quality means something. And they built up. So they are strong. But their branding is not based on their nation. Their branding is gone fuzzy. Bangladesh has still the opportunity to do this. Okay. But it is the first step for your entire industry is to make sure that brand Bangladesh is established,
yes,
the nation. Then the next step, and that is where the investment will come, when you come up with innovative ideas. Okay, for instance, textile. Right now, what I understand, I mean, I have a few friends, so I, yes, and they are into textile in Bangladesh. What they go is they go to Europe and other places and ask for the designs from them.
Yeah.
Okay. So you are secondhand always. So that next step, once Bangladesh is known to manufacture quality, the next step automatically is design. So tell me any world-class designer, you know, textile designer out of Bangladesh.
Very few.
Yeah. They're not known on the world forum. They may be known in Bangladesh. They may even be known in, let's say, Eastern India. But that's it. Okay. So to get that kind of a thing will require first the company branding. And then when he goes out asking for funds, you are touching the heart of the investors because that's his WIIFM, that he can do it. Right now, there is a little bit of suspicion, even if the idea is good.
Yes. Sir, actually, our government is trying to attract foreign investors here. The government is establishing 100 special economic zone. This special this special economic zone will be enriched with all sort of industrial logistics, transportation facilities, industrial benefits. And these are also very much linked with nearest port, whether it is a seaport or land port or airport, all sorts of connectivity. And not only this, only 100 special economic zone, we have about 78 basic industrial cluster, basic industrial estate, those who are already operating. And beside this, we have 177 SME clusters in Bangladesh, manufacturing almost 38 different types of products. So we have all these industrial logistics, industrial ingredients, but why we are performing poor in comparison with Vietnam or other countries to attract foreign investors? According to your experience, what could be the reason behind?
Only one simple word, sir, WIIFM. Okay, providing, these are hard data. What you have just said are hard data. Where is Bangladesh touching the heart of the customer? You know, then I will, you know, that's why I say, just look at that Hofstede insights. Okay, look at Bangladesh, look at the similar countries across the world, and you have it going. Number two, so you know then what is the story you must tell.
Yeah.
Okay. The next, I mean, the hard data, whatever you've given is, I mean, just about every country is trying to do it.
Yeah.
You know, there is no country. So what are you? You are only doing a me too. So where is the differentiator? You tell me.
Yes.
There has to be a differentiator. Yeah. Okay. I was listening to one interview of... you know, I don't remember the name of the president of Dhaka Chamber of Commerce. Yeah. And he's talked exactly the same thing that anybody in India is talking, or anybody in Nepal is talking, or anybody in Pakistan is talking. So where is the differentiator? You overtook India in terms of GDP growth. Why and how? What was that special thing you did that India didn't do? Let me tell you, you managed to touch the heart, the WIIFM, of the investors.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you build that into a brand, now this is the problem with us is that we have now started looking at hard data very, very end, and it's fashionable, at least in India, I can say, or let's say the Gulf, that I want to be a business analyst in this. I mean, that's all right. Again, I said, you don't look at the foundation, you look at the building for the beauty. I mean, yes. Taj Mahal is a beautiful place, but who knows what's there in the foundation? And who cares? Okay, so that is the differentiator, that branding has to be brought in. And once that happens, money will come. Now, let me give you the example of India. Bangalore is the startup capital of the country. Okay, most of the startups that we have are from the IT sector worldwide. All right, so IT India is now, you know, rubbing shoulders with the best in the world. So any startup idea coming out of Bangalore gets a better favor than, let's say, if I may have the most brilliant idea in Karjat, but there won't be a belief that this guy will be able to do it. Okay, so it is not because Bangalore, I mean, Maharashtra has as much, you know, Karjat is in Maharashtra, as much infrastructure, if not better, than Karnataka can ever dream of. All right, and it is an old established state in terms of industrialization, in terms of everything. But startups are now happening there.